Oniva Bridget has 5 children, and in a month she's expecting another one. But she's been forced to flee her home in southern Cameroon with her family to escape a military crackdown. They had to walk for a day to cross the border into Nigeria.
Our people started fighting, so I run with my children. Now as I run with my children like this, I'm suffering. No place for me to sleep, no clothes for me to wear. And now I'm pregnant, so there's no clothes. When I will deliver the pikin and I will wear the clothes, so I have nothing.
Oniva and her children are among about 7,000 English-speaking Cameroonians in this camp in Benue. English speakers like her make up less than a fifth of their country's 23 million people. They say they have been marginalized by the French-speaking majority and demanded independence, but they didn't get what they asked for.
Our problem of Anglophone started on that 1st of October when we hosted our flag, the Ambazonian flag. The government of Cameroon was not free, was not happy with this declaration of our independence. So he ordered his military. The God's youths were beaten. Some were even shot to death. Some were injured, wounded. And then on that 1st October, there was no peace in our community.
Local officials say there could now be more than 40,000 Cameroonian refugees in Nigeria. Camps like these are growing here and supplies are running out.
Most people here are yet to have breakfast. They're not even sure of supper. When they left their homes, they were only concerned about their safety.
Over 10,000, that is a big number already. For Benue State government to be feeding alone, do you understand? So there is that challenge of food. We have been given food, but that is not enough. And then there is a challenge of water. So there is need for potable water, need for that water to be treated before they drink. And then the challenge of shelter. At the moment, we have kept them in a school. The schools have resumed.
The refugees' presence here has strained relations between Nigeria and Cameroon. Cameroonian military officials accuse Nigeria of shattering insurgents. They say they want to establish an independent homeland for Cameroon's English-speaking minority. But the refugees here say what they want is enough food and water and peace. Wendy Agbo, TRT World, Benue, Nigeria.